will come up. Yeah. We're gonna turn the bass up on this one. Check it. Since 1516, minds attacked and overseen. Now call them the ruins of this empty dream. With their borders and boots on top of us, pulling out on the floor of the toxic metropolis. But how you gonna get what you need to get? The gut eaters, blood trench, get offensive like tech. The fifth sunsets get back proclaimed. The spirit of whatever.
The traffic is horrible. Monday through Friday.
I think it's bullshit. I think it's.
Bueno, de dinero, la economía está muy mal.
Thanks to them closing to other lanes, for the traffic is getting worse and it's very expensive.
All right, basically what we're doing is we're going northbound on I-95. What they did was they took the HOV lane that was on I-95 going north. They had five lanes. The far left lane was the HOV lane, and then it went fast lane, and then there were three other lanes. What they did was they took the HOV lane, and they took the fast lane, and they sectioned them off and called it the Turnpike Extension. So they made a wall there. So now, as you can see from that big sign right there, registered carpools can still take it for free. So the HOV lane hasn't been completely dismantled. However, the fast lane from the regular traffic is now taken away, and only the people with money who have $2 a day to spend can take that lane. So basically they've partitioned it into the wealthy get to go home early, the people who can't afford it have to sit here and wait an extra hour in traffic on the right side. So you're gonna see a live example of it right now as we come into it. Fast lane, is it too expensive?
I think it's fabulous.
You think it's fabulous?
Fabulous.
Why do you think it's fabulous?
Because that way I get faster.
You get faster? How about the other people that can't pay for it?
Well, I can.
You do sometimes.
Oh my god, it's terrible. Terrible!
I try to avoid it.
Get his.
Yo!
Hey! Wait, stop it. Fucking asshole. And that fucker behind us, you know, he's in the slow lane every day.
Yeah. Damn, I find that so ironic that we go out filming today and then we find someone with a sticker like that today.
I-95 North. Okay. They split it off. It used to be five lanes. They took the fast lane and the HOV lane. They cut it into the Florida Turnpike Extension. You are familiar with that?
Yeah.
I think it's bullshit. I think it's unjust. I think that I have to pay $2 or $3 to get on an extension lane to overpass traffic. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense at all. I don't understand why I have to pay that money. It should be free. I mean, they spend our tax dollars on building highways anyway, so why do we have to pay extra when you're using my tax dollars anyway?
I feel that the expressway or the express lanes on I-95 is a really good idea because, one, like if I'm trying to get to Hollywood, I don't have to be behind slow drivers. I could just take the express lane and just go over there in like 10 minutes. I have some pass, so it's not really a big deal for me. And it's just really easy because once I'm on that lane, there's like two cars, there's no traffic whatsoever. Whereas if I'm on I-95, everyone is in like in that highway trying to get, you know, to their destination, but they take forever. Whereas I can just take the express lane and get there right away. So I think it's a smart idea.
Okay, so when you go home now, does it take you longer to get home?
It takes me longer to get home.
Well, why does it take you longer to get home?
Because now it's a fucking lane for the rich people, not for the poor people like us. We work just as fucking hard as they do.
That's right.
Why should they have a fucking expressway and we don't?
That's right. Well, 95 was paid for by the citizens here.
That's right. By my motherfucking taxes too, just like yours.
Bike extension.
What about it?
Do you think it's too expensive to take home every day?
$2.20.
It's $2.20, it's ridiculous.
It is.
Yeah, well thank you for your opinion.
You're welcome.
Robin, were you paid to go home early?
Wish I was on it right now.
Yeah, no kidding.
I'm fucking done.
Okay, the express lane, I actually am against it because once they did it, the traffic on the other side gets to be hectic because they take two lanes that we used to use before. And it's like for people like me, like we cannot afford $2.50 on the rush hour every day when I'm out of work to pay it. So basically, they made a lot of people go to two, three lanes that are for everybody, and a very like certain group of people that probably they have their some passes and they can pay like $5 in 2 days for each way to use this lanes, and the lanes are almost always empty and fast, and the other lane is more narrow. And the second reason is because it looks weird, it doesn't look good. My friends were out of towners, they came here and they were like, dude, what's up with the poles on the floor? And you know, it gave the city an image, like a confusing image.
But being that I-95 alone is traffic and is crazy already, it's like if I'm on I-95, the regular highway, not on the express lane, it's a lot, like it's such a hassle to get into the lane. Like I've experienced it many times where I accidentally had to take a detour and it threw me way off instead of like fighting, trying to get into that lane to get onto the turnpike. So I understand, you know, what people are saying about how it's like not convenient for people on I-95 to get onto the turnpike north.
The price that they're going to be charging the people, it's stupid. I mean, with the way the economy is, where are the people going to get the money for?
There's no justification that where I could pay more.
That's
to leave.
Right. No, hell no. We should all be treated equal.
Okay, when you're talking about going home.
We talk about everything.
Okay.
Not just going home, everything. We should all be treated equal. The rich just like the poor.
So you're saying no matter what job you have, when you leave downtown Miami, you should be able to get home just as early
just as fast as everybody else.
No matter what kind of money you make.
No matter what kind of money I make.
Okay, so let me ask you.
Sometimes I make good money and I still can't afford to fucking get on that lane.
I actually don't have a problem with it. I mean, there's traffic, but I think that people need to get a little bit more modern and they need to start using those sun passes, and that way you get to work quicker and you're not stuck in traffic long hours or 45 minutes. I travel through it all the time, and I think it's an excellent idea.
Taking it off completely, I think we solve the problem. Stop charging people to get on, let everybody get on, and make it fair for everybody else, because the people who are obviously getting on are people who have money. Okay, if I drive an old beat up 1995 Tercel, I'm not getting on there. I'm not getting on the extension. So they should just do away with it. We have more issues that need to be resolved.
I think they should focus on other things. I do agree with that. I think maybe they should build another highway on top of the highway. Do it like Texas style. So I've heard that they have like one highway on top of the other. I think that would be cool.
If you want to get home quicker, then I think that you should put some money aside. I know that the economy is not in a position right now where there's a lot of people unemployed, but I mean, I have my savings aside, and I think everybody should have their savings. And I pay some pass on a weekly basis. I average about $50.
I think that it can be resolved by taking it off. I don't understand how they have to take the money out of our paychecks to create that road that then later we need to pay to use. I find it very pointless, and it's creating more and more traffic every day.
Is a ticket that I got going north on I-95. I was on the turnpike extension. This used to be the HOV lane. This was the fast lane. They built a wall here with these little sticks, blah blah blah, all the way up, dividing these two lanes from the other lanes that used to be here. So if you're taking I-95 north, you get a shortcut home now because of this turnpike extension if you take these lanes. Well, I was doing it because I get paid, my company pays for me to have a sun pass. So I don't have to worry about it, so I can always take the fast way home. Well, as I go over this bridge, which Miami Gardens is right here, I go over this bridge that lets down right before the Ives Dairy exit, which is 199 up this way, 199th. As you come off this bridge, it is no longer the Sun Pass Turnpike extension, it turns back into the old school HOV lane. So when you're rolling on this HOV lane, say that you just got off this bridge here and you're down here, you're rolling, you get off the bridge, you gotta get back into rush hour traffic over this way, because if not, you get fined for being an HOV. Let's see what the fine is, $154, okay? But I kinda talked shit to him, you know, I said, you know, the thing is, I said, I paid to be on this lane down here. I said, and as soon as I get off the bridge, you're waiting there for the easy pick. And you're saying, okay, cheat back here, it's okay, pay us and we'll let you cheat. But as soon as you get off the bridge, we're going to fuck you for another $154. So, I don't know, I just think it's kind of fucked up. I mean, it's kind of screwed up for these people too. You know, if they're getting off at 199, they get screwed at the HOV tickets. And there was two of them sitting there that day, and they had pulled over people all day long. So, there you go.